questions from our Facebook fans. So I'll start off and just get going. Mariana Calabacus asks us, what gets you up in the mornings when the weather is terrible and you need to train?
Well, fortunately, we actually don't get terrible weather wherever we go. I mean, we go to Australia for 3-4 months and it's always lovely, lovely sunshine. But, I mean, I've got an ethos. I always want to improve myself as a player. So whether that be just in the gym or at training, I get up, get ready to go because I want to try and improve myself as a player, ready for the next game.
And Duncan Chung asks, on a level playing field, who would you win in a fight between a hippo and a polar bear?
I don't know, it depends on the conditions, isn't it? Because a polar bear in his own backyard might be a bit tougher than the hippo on the safari. So I reckon a polar bear, to be honest.
No thick skin from the hippo?
Yeah, but a polar bear might just be a bit more savvy and get around him.
And Hugh Mabe asks, what would you consider your greatest asset to be and why?
I think my competitive spirit, never give up. I've always liked the battle of the game, and I think I play at my best when I get that level right.
Sophie Bell asks, if you could play only one more cricket match, where would it be and who would you play with?
It would be at Lord's. I would play with this current England team because I think we've got a fantastic unit together, and it would be against Australia.
Okay, and if Faye Barlow asks, if you could swap places with anyone for 24 hours, who would it be and why?
Ooh, tough question. Swap places with anyone. I think Cristiano Ronaldo has a pretty good life. I think he's certainly a sportsman I admire. David Beckham. I think Beckham, actually, because living in America and always waking up to sunshine.
Okay, and Charles Harris asks, whose wicket did you want to take the most? Ricky Gervais, Jamie Oliver, Mika, or Jonathan Ross?
I'm going to say Ricky Gervais, because he's always been a hero of mine. I think everything he does is extremely hilarious, and the nerves he had before going in was brilliant. He was so sort of nervous of the ball, was scared of the ball, so I was under pressure to make sure I got him out.
And Josh Green asks, what is your first thought on the opening day of a test match and how do you feel walking out onto the pitch?
Oh, it's a very proud moment every time you put an England shirt on and walk out playing a test match for your country. But we train really hard to make sure that when those occasions come, you're not overawed by them. So you're very focused on the skill you're going to deliver, whether it be bat or ball. So you don't think too much about the crowd or the occasion. You're just focusing on getting your skill right.
Okay, and Jackie Pearson asks, which TV show is your guilty pleasure?
Well, we don't really get to watch a huge amount of TV because if you can never get into a regular show because we're always on the road. I made it my rule this summer not to watch more than it takes to change a channel of Big Brother. And to be honest, I knew nothing that happened in the house. But I really like watching the Jonathan Ross show, and although it's just finished. I like the sort of different characters he gets on there and the way he interviews.
Fazer Farouz asks, if you could relive any moment of your life, which would it be and why?
When I look back at the final Ashes Test in 2009, there were some amazing moments in that, but because we were so focused on winning and performing, you don't really take it all in. With the crowd going wild and the atmosphere. So I'd probably like to relive that, have the same result, but take in the atmosphere.
Elizabeth Farnell asked, how does it feel to have passed your dad's highest test score?
It was a good feeling. I knew, actually. I was talking with the umpire when we were getting up there, and I said it was 162 at Perth, wasn't it? They were like, yeah, I'm pretty sure it was 162. And I hit a shot through the covers and went for four. And you can see, actually, on the replay, just a big smile on my face. I knew I'd gone past him, and all I could think was, I can't wait to text him.
Sam Bowers asks, if you could open the batting with any retired player, who would it be and why?
I think it would be Graham Gooch, because the success he'd had consistently for England. But now I work with him as a coach. He's a fantastic coach, and I learn a lot from him. So probably Gucci.
Tiffany Price asks, if you could swap places with any one of your England teammates, who would it be and why?
I'm pretty happy where I'm at the minute, actually. I think, I'll tell you what, I would be quite intrigued to see what it's like living like Swanee for a day, like always, like hyperactive talking, making jokes, like, oh, it never stopping. I've got to give him a lift home tonight from Lords to Nottingham, so I've got 2 hours of him singing and dancing in the car. So, I'd be intrigued because I'm quite laid back, relaxed, and like to have a little snooze at times, whereas he's just up and at them all the time. So it's, I wonder what, it's like he's on Red Bull all the time.
And Julie Winter asks, are you free for dinner tomorrow night?
Well, I've actually got a pack for 5 months away, but if I wasn't, then I would be, yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you, Stuart.
Cool.